I guess.
Oh my god.
Hi, I guess.
Well, so this is a thing that's genuinely happening. It seems.
It's planned for now. I don't know.
Well, this is your channel.
Yes.
Do you have some introductory words to this event?
Yes, I guess. So this weekend so far has been very interesting. We have gathered quite a bit of experience with what to do and especially what not to do in the future. And at least now we can do something good, I guess. What the fuck? Oh, well, hello. Thank you, at Catalyst Z, for the sub for 14 months. What the fuck? This will go to a good cause, namely me.
what?
But yeah, I don't want to stop Toka anymore from showing us one of the best, if not the best, GBA games. So
thanks.
Take it away.
Thank you for the very kind introduction. I appreciate it. Yes, this is Max Payne Advance for the Game Boy Advance. In case you couldn't tell. Okay. Yeah, timer
desktop.
Starts, whatever.
Desktop audio, that's what it's known for.
Oh yeah, okay. Wait. This is highly professional, in case anybody could not tell. We are
Alex and BB.
Don't worry about
that.
Do you
have some introductory words to this problem? Yeah, for the second edition we could switch games, of course. This would maybe need a bit of preparation, but I don't see why not. Anyways, 3, 2, 1, go. Yoo-hoo. Do you enjoy mocking me?
Yes.
Is it
what?
Okay, yes. Yeah, this is Max Payne game for the Game Boy Advance. I'm very prepared for this. Namely, I did exactly one run after 6 months. And I guess this is de-rusting. Maybe.
Or re-rusting.
Could be, yeah.
Yes.
It's an interesting form of symbiote. Okay, I'll take it. Believe it or not, I'll take it very safe. For some reason. Also, feel free to not bully this insane snow font. Like, what the fuck? The best thing we have to offer. Munich edition. Yeah, anyway, so this is this game came out after the PC port, I think 2 years after. This game could be from 2003, the original Max Payne, which this, of course, highly relates to, is from 2001. A lot of the levels are kind of taken over quite faithfully. Okay, please, door, hello. Taken over quite faithfully. They only scrapped, I think, two of the dream sequences and two other levels, but it's like 11 out of 15 or so. And also, if you compare the games side to side, it's actually... You can see the resemblance. Yeah, so bullet time exists in this game.
I guess.
That's a shocker. I didn't want to introduce it that soon, but... happy birthday. Okay, so for the first levels, we're using the shotgun. Because it's a very strong weapon. And in the first... I'm not even sure, I think it's the first 8 levels or so. The shotgun, or rather later the... I don't...
What is this bullying in chat? Be more respectful to the runner.
Thank you. Actually, I'm kind of focused, so I can't reach it right now. But
probably
my
don't want to.
But my friend Kataref will keep an eye on it.
Yes, I will reach donations and what? Please cheer in this chat. I mean, what?
a mini hair. What? Oh yeah, that's the right. Okay. So, well, I hope you enjoy. Yes, anyways, so yeah, the shotgun's strongest weapon for the first levels, and usually in this part you can gamble a bit. It's like 50-50 whether you die or don't die when not using the bullet timer. Hello? Oh my god. This is highly proficient movement. Trust me. Very good at this game.
I also would like to forward the question asked earlier by @70razor7.
Yes.
Asking, so guys, did you run out of anime to watch, so you decided, hey, let's do speedruns?
What? This was, thank you for the question, this was literally planned from the start.
That is not incorrect.
It was not planned thoroughly, but it was planned in principle. So I hope that counts.
And I think after yesterday's experiences, we both decided we will retire from anime. So
yes.
Take that for what
that's,
it's worth.
That's a whole other story, but that's... All I want to say is I'm still very sorry to the Japanese higher-ups who decided to visit Germany.
Yeah.
Yes. But we rudely left early. Oops. Yeah, anyways, I'm still speedrunning this game, in case somebody didn't notice. Very nice feature of this game is that you can buffer inputs, in the sense that if you hold A, Max will keep shooting. So you don't have to mass shoot, which of course is nice to make some enemy patterns or enemy kills rather consistent. Stop laughing, this is so distracting.
I'm sorry, reading chat.
Yes, I know, that's the problem.
Should I hand out fans?
Well, it's your chat and
that
your channel. Feel free to do whatever you want. Yeah, buffer shooting is very nice, especially in a few places where it's quite borderline whether you die or kill the enemy, where the window is quite tight. Because the stronger the enemy's weapon, the higher the chance of them actually killing you in the within the first frame of them encountering you.
Of course.
So that can come in handy eventually, maybe. So far, also we are in level 4 out of 11, I think. And also what you saw a few times was a save prompt after each level. And usually the default is on yes, like you want to save the game. Yes, if you mash A, you will save the game every time it loses 7 seconds. Because saving on a GBA is slow. It seems. What? Excuse me.
I'm sorry. Just taking care of my chat. @7Eraser7.
I want to leave. Help.
I mean, it's your apartment.
Yeah. So what you generally want to do, or what you rather not want to do, is you don't want to do these bullet time jumps, which you do by like casually walking or moving in some direction and pressing the bullet time button at the same time, because you cannot interrupt that action in any way other than the level end, which we'll use at the end of this level. But in principle, you want to avoid that unless you have to shoot an enemy anyways. Like for the very strong enemies at the end, it makes sense to bullet time jump, because you're shooting for a few seconds. Are you trying to distract me or...
Sorry, trying to convey my interest.
Okay, thanks for trying.
I guess.
Now I lost my train of thought, thank you. Fuck.
I will remain quiet for the rest of the game.
Appreciate it. Yeah, here there's the bullet time jump, exactly. So especially in level 10. Especially in level 10, there are very strong enemies, and there we have the M4 weapon, which is not the strongest, but it's still okay. But you, as I said, you have to shoot for a few seconds. So by using the bullet time jump while shooting these guys, you have two advantages. A, you gain some distance, and B, you have less chance of getting hit because you're in bullet time. That's one of the advantages of the bullet time mode, first place. Okay, I guess I died. Didn't see that I died, but it happened.
It's okay.
We generally have to accept that now.
For now, we have enough buffer time until I have to catch my flight. Home. You know.
Thanks.
I'm more afraid that I will go over as hard.
We shall see. Okay, so for after level 5, to the story, I'll lose all my weapons, and in particular, all my ammo. Oh. Whatever. And yeah, in particular, all my ammo. So, Duel Ingram is the strongest weapon in this game, mostly due to its high fire rate, and it being, you know, a dual weapon, would have thought that. You can use up your ammo here in this level, just because it resets afterwards anyway. Oh my god, I almost died. Good? Okay, this is level 6. Got stripped of all our weapons. That's okay because we have a baseball bat, which of course one hit kills any enemy ever. Kind of an OP weapon, but I mean, why not? Gotta say thanks and move on in your life. Also, within the corner of my eye, I saw some racism in chat. At SphereMJ. Just want to point that out casually. Now, another very nice thing about this game is that that you can skip almost every cutscene. There's only one cutscene in the game you can't skip, and also every text, like every kind of dialogue option, which makes it a very, I'd say, rather fluid speedrun.
Yes, but who would speedrun games where you can't skip cutscenes? That would be terrible.
Yes, because nobody in this room is affected by that statement, ever. Thank you.
Sometimes we indeed wish we would have talked English instead of German to each other. I can confirm, Kata. Yes.
Excuse me, what? You didn't quite catch that. Anyways, because this is a marathon.
Well done.
We had to play the piano. I didn't play the drums because I'm so insanely nervous. I hope this is not that much of a problem. Please don't ban me from your channel.
70 Razor 7 demands that you go back and shoot the piano.
What? That happened once, like, sorry. Yeah, this room, for example, this was a very nice example of weapon buffering, or shooting buffering rather. Because if you hold A during the screen transition, you will consistently shoot the two enemies, which otherwise have a very high chance of killing you. Okay, this is level 8.
I didn't realize there was a difference, to be honest.
Was das gesagt?
Jo, gut.
Was du bist, Leute? Sorry. slipped my tongue there, I think. Anyway, this level introduces a quite interesting mechanic, namely laser beams, or, well, not laser beams directly, but rather grenades at the wall which explode. And if you jump into them in bullet time, and the bullet time will stop and you'll get a quite, well, not insane boost, but it's rather mentionable, put it like that. Which will come in handy. Come in handy twice in this level and once afterwards. You'll quickly die just so I don't have to use painkillers. Of course I want to be at full health for this one. Nice. First one, usually, I give you a don't damage boost, so you have to catch these very nasty fire cycles.
Oh no.
Oops. Guess that happened. You have to make these very nasty fire cycles. Of course, jumping through is way faster anyway. So. Like, hence why we do that. Another example of buffering. Where I make it through the room without, like, doing anything. Consistently, that is. To be fair, there's some kind of downside to this buffer consistency. Namely, if your HP are rather low, Max has a higher chance of missing a shot. Although even sometimes the enemy's is right in front of you and have a shotgun, but you know, I guess that counts for nothing. But that's generally a theme in this game, so you... for some passages you want to be low health just to ensure you make it through.
7 Eraser 7 wants to point out HP hype.
Okay, so now that we are level 9, the shotgun, or rather the sawed-off, is not a one-hit kill anymore. So from here on we can use the M4 again. Because you always have a trade-off, like, of course the Duel Ingram is the strongest weapon, but you only have limited ammo. So in the PAL version you have 250 bullets, which, or a weapon with fire rate that high is not that much. And unsurprisingly, so this is intended, by the way. I said it before I died, so it's all good. It's nice because your health resets and you...
Your what resets? Sorry.
Your HP resets.
Thank you.
And the... your HP resets and you get back to the... You go back to the start of the room. So you don't have to wait for the... kind of fire cycle to align again. Which is nice. It's generally a quite interesting approach to this game, I feel like. That you have, like, you have 4 lives for each and every level, like on its own, and if you die you go back to the start of the room. Like you don't have like fixed checkpoints spread out through the level, but it's consistently every room. You die and you go back to the start.
So not very punishing.
Yeah, that's fitting. I was slow, in case anybody could not tell, but that's fine. That's my life. Another boost you can make. Because, as you saw, you can destroy these wall grenade things by shooting at them, but especially when those are... But I mean, you have these kind of chains, so the first explodes, and then the second, and the third takes a long time, so it's jumping through. It's a bit fast because you also cover some distance at the same time. So this is the first and only cutscene of the game we have to watch. It's epic, by the way. And that was it.
I feel betrayed.
Oh, do you?
Yes.
Sorry.
Because I know what's coming up after this run.
Oh, do you?
Yes.
I'm sorry.
But I did not make the schedule, so it's not on me. I guess.
right, because there was no way you could have said, could you please change the schedule? No, it's impossible. I understand that. That's totally fine. Stupid scheduling thing. Like, didn't even include Prince of Persia. The fuck? It's not like the only run I could kinda do at the moment is worry with an NMG, and that takes a bit longer than 20 minutes, so... Then again, I'm not the one who has to catch a flight today. Not
That's
my problem.
Also cool.
Okay, so for me, we can use the Dueling Room again because we collected enough ammo throughout the run so far, or at least starting from level 6, because that's when our weapons got reset. Just so we can start using it here and approximately find until the end of the game. I didn't think the cutscene would extend that far. It's actually bad in two regards, because I wanted to pick up the ammo, the Dueling Room ammo, but the guy was too close to the... was actually inside the cutscene. So, kinda have to be careful with that. I guess I'll take painkillers. Which in this game is the way to heal yourself. I don't think I explained that so far. Another way you can heal yourself is, but that's not really fast, even if it's a if it's done quickly. You can also die exactly due to this mechanic of going back to the start of the room whenever you die. That can also be a nice, or rather safe way reset your HP if you're low on painkillers. Because interestingly enough, the variable for the painkillers counts up to 8, so you can't pick up more than 8 painkillers. Which is fair, because of course the highest value in the Game Boy Advance RAM is 8 anyways. There's nothing, nothing beyond that. So that's the part I was talking about. Here you can just jump, because these guys take so many bullets anyways. That you at the same time can cover some.
Maybe I can forward another question from chat.
No, please don't. Okay,
okay.
No, please do.
At SphereMJ asks, what is this 30 minutes estimate?
Damn. I mean, that's a fair point in principle. Then again, as I said before, I did one run before this marathon, like precisely before it. That was the first run I did of this game in 6 months, so I hope you understand how to go a bit safe on this one.
I would also like to point out that you may want to look at the game tags, which are automatically attached to the screen when you select this game.
Yes. Apparently this is a visual novel. I'm sorry. I don't even think you can get rid of that tag, can you?
No.
Automatically generated. Cool. Okay, so these enemies are the most dangerous, simply because they have dual Ingrams as well, so... Of course, the weapon's very nice when you have it, but when the enemies have it, and you don't use bullet time, you may have a bad time. Putting it very vaguely here, of course. But you gotta be rather careful. Ah, come on. Absolute twat off. Didn't want to have ammo anyways for the last level. Whatever. Like, fuck. Okay. Last level. And this is a rather short one, but it also introduces the most, yeah, I think you can say the most fun weapon. It's the grenade. Yes, my absolute favorite. I'm not sure why they included that in this game, but that's like we have to live with it now anyway, so whatever. The problem with these grenades is the position you have to be in, such that the steel beams are hit, is quite precise. As you
apparently
see here, QED, proof N, oh my. Now the chopper stopped, and I guess the story ends. Maybe. I don't know.
Well underestimated.
Yes. Sadly, I didn't play the game in German, so we don't get the storm seemed honey screen in the end where it says, Glückwunsch, Sie haben Max Payne advanced. Sorry.
You can't imagine.
So that's 6 minutes I can go overestimate as well in my next run.
No, because we still have to watch this cutscene,
okay,
which takes 6 minutes.
Trust me.
The cops' voices were distant and muted.
Why is this English? Because I messed up, I guess. Sorry.
My ghosts released me from their haunting.
Nothing.
Below,
I mean,
New York City glittered like diamonds on.
I can try something. Because we have the time anyways. So what if I just start the last level now? I think it still gives you the screen one I have here. That way you can also these grenades. Oh come on, dude. Worst part is that this fight is on a timer, and it can happen, and it actually has happened before, that I missed so many grenades that I lost the fight. And time! Insane.
Is this IL world record?
Yes.
Good.
Because this game has
first
an IL
world record in Toka Marathon history.
Okay, and?
Oh, there we go.
I think this is a rather nice screen to end the first run of this marathon. You'll see me later again. I'll show off another run this marathon. I'm very thankful for it. Thanks to the schedule team. Whoever decided what's shown here, highly appreciate it. So yeah, next up is some weird Tomb game, I think.
I'm not sure either, but I pressed some buttons.
See you in 5 minutes. We'll be right back.
Leicht nicht so leicht. Oder?
Nope.
Sicher?
Ah. Schön B.
Ja, wobei, wenn ich jetzt nicht hier. I guess we're live again. Oops. Hope you enjoyed that very well produced intermission.
I did my best.
Sure.
Or maybe the game's audio? Is it loud or not?
I don't know.
Not sure what your standard is for this.
I don't either.
Okay, so it's like okay. I'll do a third. If the game's too quiet or anything, chat can just speak up.
Yes. But yeah, as you can tell, this will actually be in German. There will be some cutscenes, I guess. Sorry. And yeah, those will be in German. Because that's my gift to this wonderful country, which hosted me for 2 days.
Okay. Is the game still too loud? Put it like 30%, but I can also turn it down. Also, loud is correct. Sorry to inform you. Okay. Like, guess we'll see.
So, ich habe fast nichts. It's okay, I don't think I need audio cues in this game, but
I mean, if you do, this is all I can do for you.
It's okay, but yeah, I guess we'll just start. What is split button?
7.
7,
I see. Because that makes sense. At Knight Rider.
Okay, yeah, then I guess here we go. We actually did go. Okay, but yeah, this is Tomb Raider The Last Revelation, better known as Tomb Raider 4, or as the experts call it, Tomb 4. And the reason why this and basically any game in the Tomb Raider franchise is called Tomb in the community is because German, I guess. I will explain more after this jump, which I will fail.
It's too quiet, okay. Whenever you want to go into the pause menu, all good. This is highly professional.
Yes. Maybe this works now.
Das erste Hindernis.
Valtrek is dead now. That is very true. However,
false.
No, because world record holder is actually in chat now, and it is not me. But yeah,
das hier.
Nice. Will I even make this? Yes, good. So the reason why everybody calls these games Tomb in the Tomb Raider community is that apparently, I can't confirm this because I was not around back then, but in ye old days, apparently the Germans always pronounced it as they would when they read it in German, which would be Tomb Raider. So apparently that left an impression, and it's now forever shall be called Tomb. So that's some interesting lore, I guess. But yeah. In this game we start out as young Lara, as you can tell. Young Lara, I think I can speak, maybe. Young Lara does not have any weapons or flares, so the tutorial mission here will be rather boring, I guess. Except for some tricks like those. So what you saw there is called a corner bug. In this game, when you go out of bounds, the game tries to push you out on top. And if there is collision on top of where you go out of bounds, that's where you end up. I hear some laughing to the right of me, but I will not question it.
The Adventures of Lars Kraft. Shoutouts to I Fail 22.
But yeah, basically in the tutorial it's just that. So you're with this old guy behind me, he's Austrian, so that's fine.
Excuse me, what?
It's my channel, it's okay. He's Werner von Kroy, who may or may not be mentioned in a different run later on. Not sure. So he's your mentor and he's supposed to tell you all the kinds of tutorials. But sometimes I'm almost certain that I know some stuff about this game, other times I'm not. And yeah, so basically for now we just try to get out of here because that's when I will get weapons and more importantly flares, which will be put to good use, I guess. As you can see, we have a stamina meter. This is the second game where that was used. The first one was Tomb Raider 3. I'm sorry, Tomb 3. So in this game, stamina just regenerates after you've used it, and in Tomb Raider 3 you actually had to wait until it was fully regenerated before you could sprint again. I think they saw that that was pretty stupid, so at least that was fixed. And this is the first big cutscene. Get used to them, kinda. So in this game there are a few of them, but not too many. The one after this is a bit more infamous, I guess. From what we've timed, it's out of the 55 minutes, we have 23 minutes of cutscenes in that run, which is fun. And this one, it's much less, but the tutorial level is the one who gets hit the worst, I guess, because of this and another one a bit later on. But yeah, this is where Lara finds her backpack, which is now part of her jacket texture, I guess. And yeah, cool lore. We also tried going into those spikes yesterday, but it did not do anything.
But you can stand inside them without getting hurt. Just want to point that out.
That is correct. So yeah, we're out of here again, because now actually this gate is open, which is the only reason why we went in there. And now we have to dive through the gap, or as he says in German,
tauchen Sie durch die Öffnung.
Tauchen Sie durch die Öffnung.
There we go.
Tauchen Sie durch die Öffnung. Drücken Sie springen, um eine Tauchrolle auszuführen.
I did not mean to put you on the spot. I was actually waiting for the.
No, I was thinking myself what he says there.
I see.
Der Garten der fünf.
Of course, I know the German dub quite well of this game.
Zu Ihrer Linken erkennen Sie den Pfad. This is almost glitchless. I'm happy you did not listen to me earlier or watched the run, in fact. So yes, for now this is glitchless. And it will definitely remain glitchless after I went into the inventory there. Don't worry about that.
Okay. So is it better than glitchless or...
yeah.
Percent?
Sadly, I'm not actually playing this, or I don't know the glitchless route for this, so I can't judge.
Jetzt.
And here we try to do another corner bug to get up there. And swing on the rope, which was first introduced in this game, and it is very fun, I guess.
It's funny, I know of another game where swinging on ropes is fun. Came out around the same time, I think.
I will miss the
slow. Oh, hello, Epic Dude Guy.
Hello, Robbie. I'm sorry for not informing you about this earlier.
Unrelated reference.
But yeah, so that was the first level. Now the second one will be a lot shorter. This will just be a race against Werner. But as you will see, he cheats at the beginning. He gives you a countdown and he starts running at 1 and never comes down to 0. So that's mean.
I mean, running is a very, you know...
which legitimates me in, like, actually doing a bit of liberal interpretation of rules later on, I guess.
It's weird, that's a very good point. So as I said in the beginning, the idea for this being a thing was around for longer, but the exact schedule and everything was only planned at 9 a.m. today, so I'm sorry.
And by planning, I mean Toka sending me a link of the schedule and I was like, yes.
Yeah.
And German is actually not faster than any other language. Language does not matter in this game at all. Unlike some other Tomb games. Maybe one of those will be run later on.
Some other what games?
Tomb games.
Thank you.
No worries. But yeah, and this is German because I installed it as German. That's the only real reason.
What is causality?
And here we try to another corner bug because I can cheat as well. And then we're done with Cambodia, if I can get around the corner. Yes, this game was released on PC, originally on PSX, but it sucks to run, so I will keep that in mind at 70Razor7. But yeah, so this cutscene I think is around 2 minutes or something,
oh.
But
there will not be one, a longer one like this for a bit, so bear with me.
Is it true that if you press N and P alternatingly, that the cutscene will end? Oh no.
Apparently not.
Damn. We tried so many things yesterday to skip cutscenes in this game.
But yeah, as you may have seen earlier, you can actually skip the shorter tutorial in-game cutscenes where the camera is focused on Werner and he talks. You can just simply skip those by pressing the look key, but these are so important and integral to the story. They should not be skipped. Yes, I fell. These bigger ones... Like, there are also FMVs, which we actually completely skip by disabling them. But these you cannot skip. Yes, there is in
Stop.
Fact Tom on GV.
Bye. I leave. I am aware, but I don't want to be.
So yeah, basically, Werner here thinks it's a good idea to remove this artifact, despite the big warning on the stone plate Lara just spelled out. What could go wrong? I don't know. What footy said? Yes.
What exactly did Werner say? Could you please read that for me?
What?
I didn't quite know what Werner said there. Something about his leg?
Maybe.
Was it?
Okay. There are rumors that there exists a Swiss-German dub of this scene, but I want to refute that claim. But yeah, that's Cambodia. From now on, the rest of the game will play in Egypt. As grown-up Lara, which also means we have weapons, and after a few seconds I will also collect my first flares, which shall serve me quite well, hopefully. As you can see, this place heute. Period. So these are flares, better known as magic wands, I guess, because they're probably the most or one of the most broken things in this game. So they originally are just meant to brighten up the environment, but there are some other use cases, I guess. So my next goal will be to unlock a big gate in the next room. For that I need two key items, one of which I will collect in a side room here. And here you will also see a first application for Flare. One of the really important ones. So if I drop a Flare next to a wall and turn around and pick it up, I will go out of bounds. And as I explained earlier, when you're out of bounds, the game will try to push you out on top, which is handy. And you also saw maybe the second application there. So the animation of Lara throwing away her flare takes priority over stumbling animations when you fall down, which means we can avoid the 1 second stumbling animation whenever we have a flare.
Oh, okay. Clever.
Like here, for example, I will do that again.
Is that rope in the room of any use? Do you know that?
Legend. I almost said the cursed word.
Yes.
I'm sorry. That's what this game does.
Rumor has it.
Rumors has it. That apparently this can take you someplace else. But I don't know. This is not a secrets run, luckily. So let's ignore it for now. But yeah, this is the gate we need to open. Here we go. Sorry about that.
Nice spoiler, by the way. I thought the rope leads to a launch which kills you. So that's the intended thing. Okay, sorry.
Okay, and so next I need to get inside this statue's head. I'll just do some safety saves here, I guess. So this would also require some
longer puzzle, but I have flares. So let's see what we can do. This looks suspicious. I might have to re... I don't think this will work. Let's just try again. But basically what I want to do is I want to place two flares there and then repeatedly pick them up while going backwards. And what that will allow me to do is apparently something...
No.
What? If there's anything interesting in chat, just tell me.
No,
because I'm kind of distracted by a game.
I know how you feel.
Good.
I felt the same earlier.
Let's try this. But yeah, this is basically what I'm trying to do here. As you can see, by repeatedly picking up the flare, Lara moves backwards. And at the top of this tunnel here, there should be just enough space where I should fit in. Like this. And then... Thank you. And yeah, that's the rest of this level. Skip. And we're off to the next one, where we will first use the other magic tool we have, called the binoculars. So basically this game was kind of the predecessor to Dark Souls 2, because you have a stamina bar and binoculars are really broken.
It's a rather strong statement you're making there, but okay.
I checked, this actually came out before Dark Souls 3, so I'm fine.
Alright.
But yeah, once again I will go out of bounds here. Since there's no collision on top, it will not push me out on top. But I can use my Fernglas, I guess, to hit a cutscene trigger. So what happens there is, when Lara is usually the entity who can interact with triggers. And if she's out of bounds, so not on the active map, there is like another list of priorities which or actors that can do that. So there are like enemies can then start to interact with triggers. Flares also count as actors. And the object with the least priority, which then can interact with triggers, is the camera itself. So if we make sure that Lara is out of bounds and nothing else is on the active map, we can actually use the camera to interact with triggers, which is what I did there. So I was out of bounds. And I placed the camera where it would be on the same square as the trigger for this cutscene. And at the end of that cutscene, Lara always spawns there, so that's nice.
But the drawback of that, if I'm not mistaken, is that you can't move out of bounds.
Out of bounds, you cannot
move. Once your position is fixed, that's... You can't really...
You can sometimes get out again if you're close enough to the wall. Like, if you don't embed too deep into out of bounds, you can, like, jump out again.
Yeah.
But bad things can happen. And now it's just a question of getting out of here. Here again, flare cancel. I healed. Oops. But yes, this game has a somewhat remarkable healing sound, which you might want to get used to. No spoilers. So yeah, now I want to get up on top here. I wonder how that would work. Then here I already want to hold down the flare key. So Lara actually takes out the flare at the start of this cutscene. Because as I said earlier, flares count as active entities. So when I want to do triggers by being out of bounds with the camera or different things, then I don't want an active flare on the map. That's why it's safe there. There is a trigger in front of me. I don't want to have... Jesus Christ, stop. Stop. No. There we go. Speedrun. But yeah, basically I want this flare to go out as early as possible. So I want to start it as early as possible. Hello at Boomer Street.
To confirm what chat said, yes, we are currently at my apartment. If apartment is a fitting word, not sure of that.
I don't know languages, it's fine. But yeah, some more abusing of flares here before we come into the most action-packed level, as Toka can confirm.
Yeah, that's
and
right.
Anyone who has watched me do runs of this can confirm as well. So again, here I want to hit the trigger. This time actually the level and trigger. Maybe this works. Please. Thank you. No, wait, I need to focus.
Oh, sorry. I thoroughly apologize for my interruption.
Oh no, what could I do? So yeah.
What happens if you press N, by the way? Like if you hold N, is there anything?
Do I want to try?
Not sure. What does happen? Oh, okay. Hmm.
But yeah, basically we're out of bounds now. And as I explained earlier, some other entities take over the ability to interact with triggers.
Okay.
And basically the first ones are always enemies. And as you may have seen there, at the start of the level, there is an enemy in a car which drives away. So now that we're out of bounds, that enemy has the ability to hit triggers. So what we do for the rest of the level is stay out of bounds and wait for him to reach the level end trigger.
Yeah, that's nice.
Which is very good, because otherwise I would have to drive the car and you don't want to see me drive that car.
Hope you're focusing hard enough, by the way.
I'm just hoping it still works, because I usually don't hold the look key, but it should work. Thank you for this. This is now a co-op speedrun.
Yes.
So yeah, that was that exciting part. There will be more flare and binoculars shenanigans from here on out. So Tom 4, I remembered to call it correctly this time. Is by far the longest if you play it casually. Like, they really went complete ham here.
Luckily, overboard.
A bit overboard. Luckily, with flares and binoculars, we were able to cut down the time quite a bit. Where it is now very much in line with the times you can get for the other classic Tomb Raiders. And by classics, there is some discussions whether the classics go from 1 to 5 or 1 to 6, with 6 being Angel of Darkness. You probably have heard of that game, and I don't want to go into details.
So what's your opinion on that matter?
Do
you want to disclose that? Or?
Yes. I want to say that it's definitely going from 1 to 6. Because of certain things that are still in AOD, which don't work in Legend onwards. And yes, I'm sorry, I apologize for saying Legend.
It's your channel, whatever.
Okay, so here I'm trying to do a flare jump to get past this door. So if you have a flare on one side... I missed. What? Wait, did I? No, I did not miss. If you have a flare on one side of a wall while Lara's on the other side and she tries to pick it up, she slides backwards to pick it up, but during that time you don't have collision. So if you also jump forward, you win. But it's always a fixed distance you go like that, so you cannot jump like too far, I guess. Hello, CXY. Don't question what is happening.
You don't either.
At Catalyst Z, wowee. Then here I have to actually do some puzzling. Though you will see that's quite a strong word for what I will be doing. So I need to hit two switches down here to open the next area. Which is already rather complex for this game. Might actually be the most complex puzzle we're solving.
So what happens if we activate the wrong switch?
I think... Actually, I... What the... Okay, thank you. And one of them is also an item. I think it's a med pack or something. And I'm not sure if in the other one there is a trap. Could be, I don't know. I try to avoid the wrong ones.
Okay. Thought you still remember your casual playthrough, which definitely happened.
It actually happened, but a long time ago, by which I mean half a year. Why am I embedding for this? And I think at 7 Eraser 7 has a question to Orga.
Maybe.
So we're now approaching the end of this level. This is actually the last part of this level. These doors are very cool. At CXY, please look at the tags of this stream. Hello. It clearly says both marathon and practice.
Yes, this is a marathon, allegedly.
Kinda, I guess. So here we flare jump into the wall, into the void. So now I actually could not move. I want to adjust the camera and then look at where I want to go. And apparently where I want to go is a train. Ooh. Because I'm out of a tomb. This is no longer Tomb Raider. I mean
just Tom. Train Raiders. The Adventures of Lars Kraft.
But yeah, so this is the somewhat infamous train level. What we basically have to do is go from one end to the front and then all the way back again, because that's fun. All just so we can pick up a crowbar to use on the switch you can see there on the right. That's the only way to really activate it. So we can go to the level exit. Now this.
Can't you just do that in the first place? Lamu.
just hit the trigger, like whatever. So yeah, there aren't too many glitches in this level, which means this is rather movement focused, which means I suck at it. So you will see me do some weird jumps there, like that one. What I do there is I skip cutscenes and enemy triggers. So you saw a guy there arriving on a car. Whenever I would hit one of those cutscenes, a guy would, you know, the cutscene would play and I would be frozen in place for like 10 seconds, and that's stupid. Here I try to do a setup, because on the card after the next one, you see this green tarp. You would actually slide down if you would land on the slopes. And I don't want that. So with that setup, you always land on top, which is actually otherwise a rather precise jump. And by precise, I mean impossible. This cutscene we could also skip, but it is so precise that it is not worth it. No, because I say that because even the world record runner at Footy doesn't do it, I think.
Fair enough. I just want to appreciate the existence of a chopper in this game for some reason.
And now we're actually at the end of this train. So in here will be the crowbar and some other goodies. Like that shotgun there, which in my case will just give me ammo, but why not?
At what point do you get the dual Ingram in this game?
I have unlimited ammo for my dual guns, I'm sorry. But they're sadly not the strongest weapon.
It's a shame.
I know. And then here I will try to do another corner bug. Maybe I should not have saved there. Oh, there we go. Perfect. And now I go back and have to once again skip the cutscenes I already skipped the first time. This time. There we go. That was one. And now I just have one left. Allegedly the easier one, but the one I tend to screw up. But it worked. Ooh. Thank you. Hello at Exonerous.
Here?
Yes. And that's the end of the train level. Now, you may want to pay attention here, because actually Lara exits in a rather weird way, I guess. But yeah, oops. That's that level. Now we're off from the train. Hello, at Exonerous again. This is my co-host, Tokalon.
I am the scheduling team.
All complaints regarding the schedule can be directed at Tokaloni 1. So yeah, now we're obviously in Alexandria. As you can tell by the, I'm sure, very detailed recreation. I'm sorry.
Evidently.
At 70 Razor 7, it's of course at Tokaloni 1. So, since I have not been in a Tomp recently, and this is Tomp after all, next goal would be to go into the Tomp, I mean Temple of Osiris. No, it's Iris. Isis, I'm sorry. What is Egyptian mythology? Not my strong suit, apparently. So let's see what Lara thinks about this run. Is it any good?
No.
Okay, I tried.
What's the opposite of yes?
What is nine in English?
No.
Smart girl.
So now I once again use the flare to get up on top of this collision because there would actually be a longer cutscene to my right. And I don't want to watch cutscenes because then I could play Tomp 5, which evidently I'm not. Luckily, thanks at scheduling team. Because this is how you obviously enter the Temple of Isis. And now we actually are supposed to have two key items to open the gate. You can see it.
You're just saying key items?
Yes.
Okay.
which you're supposed to get in like a rather long maze and different side areas, but obviously I don't. Thank you at Nightbot for promoting my Discord. Very kind of you. So yeah, what we can, since we don't have those items.
Thank you.
We can actually do a different trick. So this is called the keyhole glitch. If you're out of bounds next to a keyhole, so like a thing where you have to put in a item or a key, if you're out of bounds next to it and you have a flare, then again Lara wants to interact with it, but since the keyhole is closer, the game assumes he wants to interact with the keyhole, and it just, I guess, gives you the item because it's very generous. So same again over here.
So I apologize for the noise I'm making. Apparently I'll be quiet for the rest of the marathon.
That would be a shame. So that's both key items inserted, both keys inserted. I will now proceed onwards, which will actually bring me to the probably worst lookup trigger. So the thing with the binoculars, it's pretty infamous how bad this next one is. But there has been a setup which may come in handy.
What are these quotation marks? Like,
they are I'm trying to symbolize that I suck at this game.
I just want to thank Eraser for advertising non-Tokareffthon for everybody who feels left out. Somebody in chat asks, well, the option is to donate for a 24-hour stream.
You can
please
donate,
enlighten them.
In subscriptions or cheers. I mean, what? So here's where we'll do just that setup, which I probably already don't remember anymore. So go me. Let's see. So this is, as I said, rather finicky. I almost screwed up already. Good. This looks bad, but we will see. Oh, there we go. That looked actually really good apparently. So now we're out of the Tomp again, and we're now in Cairo, as you can see. And we're driving something. And from this point onwards, as I warned you earlier, you might want to get used to Lara sighing a lot, which is a metaphor because of how much I suck at this game. but it's actually the sound she does when you heal her. And as you may be able to tell, I heal her quite a lot, which is weird since I did not pick up any medkits. And you will see why I need to heal her a lot in like 10 seconds.
Is it because you're bad at the game and you get hit a lot, or?
I actually enabled the unlimited medpack cheat.
Oh, okay.
But don't tell them. But yeah, so here I get set on fire. As you can see, fire obviously drains your HP constantly.
Merci beaucoup.
But a bit good. And this will, like, you're set on fire until you either die, I guess, or you go into water. It does not go out on itself. Or it does not extinguish, I'm sorry. Hello at one stay.
What is anime, honestly? This whole weekend, there was
too much.
There was no kind of contact to any anime.
Yes. So yeah, get used to Lara sighing, as I said. So the reason why I have this many med packs, I'm always using large med packs, is in Cambodia, I shortly mentioned that I opened the inventory. I will explain more once I'm past this thing. Nice clip of the motorbike. That makes sense, I guess. Because there is a guy I need to kill on top here, because soon I will again use my binoculars, so I must not have any other active enemies on this map. But basically what I did in Cambodia is I did an underflow on my large medpack count. So you can use medpacks in this game by either selecting them in the inventory or using a hotkey. However, for whatever reason, on the very last, if you only have one medpack left and you use the hotkey, the counter decreased by one, but you don't get any benefit from it. So what I did is I first used the last large med pack in the... What is happening in chat? Why am I doing this? I first used the large med kit with a hotkey, which decreased my counter to zero. And then I used it again the normal way by selecting it, which set it once again lower. Which now gave me basically around 64,000 large medkits. But I think...
Will that suffice? Or?
I think that's actually intended, because if we look here, the game actually says unbegrenzt, so it says unlimited medkits, so I think this is intended. Thank you, at core. I like how my chat completely turned into anime now. But what is anime? Weeps may be out. It's your choice. So since we did not have a cutscene for a longer time, you may now talk about anime. As you can see, Lara is still on fire. In these in-game cutscenes...
On fire!
Yes, I know.
100
in
emojis.
In-game cutscenes, you don't take damage while she's on fire. During flyby cutscenes, however, if you enter a new area, she still does take damage, so if you don't heal during those, you will end up with a dead Lara afterwards. At Caramels, please sponsor me.
At Caramels, your website looks straight out of 2006. Set by Sphere. So we'll make you aware. Please go with the time.
Lara, und sie halten sich ausgezeichnet, Sergeant. Sie haben die Codes. Was jetzt?
So... Here, this guy, you were supposed to first meet him, and then he gives you some, I guess, side quests where you have to upgrade your bike to make longer jumps and whatnot. But since we kind of used our binoculars to go all over the place, the first time you meet him is actually from the side where you're supposed to come from last. So he just meets Lara, who's set on fire for the first time, and she just carries him off. Because I guess that makes sense. Thank you for plugging at Caramels, because I'm sure Caramels has a Twitch channel. I have not checked yet.
I hope so.
But yeah, as you can see, Lara is no longer on fire. Sorry. I would say something about how good the pace of my run is, but I don't know. I assume not good. But yeah, actually,
shouldn't you know at every point in time how good the run is?
Actually, apparently Lara is still on fire. So this will continue. So to my right is another cutscene, which I want to skip with a stupid setup. And another flare jump. I'm not sure if this will work. Luckily, I saved. There we go. Oh, well, that's bad. Can I alt F4 and the game will pop up again? Sure, okay. Ignore that. What the fuck happened now?
The whole screen breaks apparently, but that's fine.
Where is the thing?
Could just go into Dig's wind and then...
Correct.
Start from there.
Highly professional. This one?
I guess, yeah.
I don't know. Just asking.
Minimize it, by the way. Oh no, just well. All good.
All good. Hi. Yeah, this is Tomb Raider. What? Next try, I guess. I wasn't quick enough on the alt F4. This does not make me positive when it comes to Angel of Darkness later on. But yeah, this is how we skip that cutscene, because we don't want to rescue our old friend, I guess. I'm not saying that he's French, but he's French.
What?
I'm sorry. Well, technically we have never met him, so we also did not get abducted.
J'ai une question.
Pourquoi?
Pourquoi?
Now I need to get rid of this flare. Also, yes, Lara has to use... not flare, this torch. Lara, in fact, has to use a torch to light things up despite being on fire herself. Because, yes. But I had to get rid of it because it also counts as an active entity. And as we know by now, if I have active entities on the map while being out of bounds, those take priority over the camera, which I don't want to. But this is one of those flyby cutscenes where I actually need to heal Lara. Otherwise, it does not turn out well. Nice, I guess. And you also saw a guy run up the stairs there. Since he's there, I need to get rid of him as well. For which I collected a nice grenade launcher. And that should have been the last entity other than Lara on the map. And after this flyby cutscene, I will then go to the next level, for which we will get another cutscene. I'm sorry. First, I will pick up some more grenade launcher ammo, because it's amazing.
Did someone say grenade?
Launcher.
Okay.
The GL.
It stings, but only 50%.
So I'm sorry for this flickering, but this actually shows me that there are no other active entities on the map. Because that makes sense. And then maybe here is the trigger. It was there. It werfs Granaten. Yes.
And clipped.
I was about to say something in Swiss German, but I restrained myself because I know what consequences it could have.
I feel like the only person who clips these kind of things is me, and I'm kind of, you know, could be rather difficult to do this now.
Why is there still anime talk in my chat? Lara is in fact on fire, but as you will see at the end of this cutscene, there might be salvation.
Danke. Aber davon habe ich schon mehr als genug.
But first, lore, I guess.
Gib einem Schakal die Hand und der beißt gleich in den ganzen Arm.
Which brings us to this rather iconic moment, where Lara now closes the door, and because of these jackals, she would say in English, barking mad, because that's smart. While in German, she says, kläfft wie ein Irre, which is also very smart,
yes.
I guess. But yeah, as you can tell, or you could tell from the sound here, she plunges into a liquid, which turns out is not water, so sorry for debating.
Au revoir les chiens.
Somebody actually clipped that.
Oh my god. I'm sorry. This one is on me.
At Eiffel 22. So, two enemies here, which I don't want. grenade launch.
Seems like Zonarius wants to talk about something to you.
I see weep and I reject it on a personal way.
But if you stay until after the marathon, there's like a 20-minute Q&A. Oh,
no. I'm not sure if I actually skipped the trigger here. Let's see. I did skip the trigger. Amazing.
Is that good or?
That is actually good, okay. Yeah. It's because if you just walk up there normally, there would be two guys spawning here, which would be two more guys I would have to kill. And those actually may not die from just one shot with the grenade launcher, so that's what why you actually always want to skip that trigger. And I picked up the handle of a shovel there, which you would need in the casual playthrough. You need to collect the handle and the spade to form a complete shovel to dig up the entrance to the next level. However, obviously since I have binoculars, I also know how to get in the temple in a different way. But I still collect these key items for reasons. It's not like there would be anything weird happening in the game if you carry over key items
yes.
from one level into the next where they're not supposed to be.
Okay. I just want to kindly ask Razor to please stop. You know what you did.
What do you mean I exploded that guy? What? What just happened? And here is the spade. And now, since I have both of them, which I, as I said, technically don't need, but I want to have, here we go, I guess. I see begrenzt and I cringe.
What?
So, welcome to the best level, I guess. If best is defined as tortures you non-stop, that was already bad. So there is a what we call a portal, so kind of like if you go through that gateway there, can I stop running instead of jumping? It will shut down and you actually cannot get past it even like with all our fancy tricks, so we want to avoid that obviously. So I need to flare jump past this, hopefully. How did this even work? I think I tried this before this run, but apparently I forgot.
Count to 12.
No, because okay. I'm using a different setup, which is actually safe.
Okay.
Unless you forget about it. Okay, and then now we need to go into three side rooms, collect some items, which you unlock by pressing these buttons in certain orders. So at home I have a cheat sheet, which I don't have here. So
you have a what?
What could go wrong? I have noted down certain things to remember me, to remind me of what to do because I'm old.
Okay.
Sorry.
So in some sense noted the Aufbau of this room, you want to say.
Stop, please.
2, 3, 1.
So I hope you still enjoy the healing sound because it will be over now. Sorry. But yeah, there are, is usually a question, is why is she set on fire and can you avoid it? And the answer to the first one is, well, I answered that already because I went past the fire of flamethrowers. You can actually avoid it. It actually only saves around 10 to 15 seconds if you take the flamethrowers. But I've never done it any other way, so I don't know. I mean, I tried to do the route where you avoid them, but I'm still getting set on fire, so just forget about it. And after healing myself for like the past 10 minutes constantly, it's actually not unthinkable that I will still press the heal key every now and then, just because I'm used to it. Of course, now it does nothing. And also, it's rather a jarring change from constantly hearing Lara sigh to nothing. because we actually just have to swim through this water maze and hit a certain amount of switches until we get to the last room where the item we want is.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
And hopefully I don't get lost here, because that would also be something that would be written down in my notes.
Have you ever gotten lost in this water maze? Ever?
Yes.
Question mark.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. But thank you for bringing up my dark past. Not that the present would be less dark. But yeah, actually, I mean, not really lost, but I definitely lost like a significant amount of time, because I then also panicked. But yes, I have in fact gotten at least lost like half a minute, because I'm smart. Not. Yeah, so basically what we're doing in this temple is we first collect, or we are supposed to collect, 4 items to proceed to the final area, where we will collect 4 more items which will then be used in the very final level to awaken the god, which of course everybody cares about because lore in this game. But yeah, we need those 4 items at the very end, and to get to those we need the 4 items before that. So if we could find some way to not need those 4 items at the very end, we could skip this level entirely, because that is very well possible. And that was the first item that we need to get to the final area. So now I just need 2 more, even though I said you technically need 4, but maybe the shovel from earlier on may play a role. I don't know.
What's your opinion of bats, by the way? Quite a random question.
Is this a loaded question?
I may or may not have personal interest in your answer. But.
Well, I can tell you, in this game, they're among the worst things to encounter.
Okay.
Does that make you happy or not?
I'm not sure yet.
Okay.
Still processing.
Now, the next side room is a lot less spectacular than that really spectacular water maze, I guess. There are bats and there are 9 switches. You just need to hit 2 and you're done. Because this one unlocks the entry and this one has the item.
So what happens if you activate the wrong switch?
I'll just leave that question open.
Okay.
Please consult a walkthrough for this.
It's for the interested viewer to check out for him or herself. For themselves, I'm sorry.
I may or may not know which buttons to press here, but I think it is this order. We will see shortly, because if it's not, then the entry will not be unlocked.
2, 3, 1? Oh wait, still the wrong game. So sorry.
It was the correct one, by the way. So after the previous puzzle was already really difficult, this one is even more difficult. So this is a room with now 4 switches and 1 lever. And the solution is to just pull everything. Like, nice. Oh, and there are crocodiles, but whatever. So this unlocks the entry again.
Eraser, I will pay no attention to you. I'm just pointing that out here.
I actually cannot pay attention, but if there's anything
you
worthwhile...
Nothing. You missed
okay.
Nothing.
That's what I wanted to know. I think Exonerous' question you can answer yourself.
Sadly, not. So sorry.
We don't want to steal your fire before the speedcon...
Finales. Which we are very much looking forward to, let me tell you that much. Also, the schedule is in the title, for anybody who didn't notice it yet.
So if I can get this jump, we're actually off really well, this looks good, okay. So if you don't load at all in this level, you can actually completely ignore most of the bats, which so far I did. The ones in the next room I need to kill. The reason is that if you load the list of priorities, who can interact with which trigger gets changed. But if we don't load, then actually the two statues at the very start of the run have higher priorities than bats, so we can just ignore them. Then here comes the shovel, which if you combine them just turns into one of the key items here. The reason, as I said earlier a bit, is you're not supposed to have the items here, but they still have the same ID combined than the item we need to unlock this door. So we can skip one of those. And this brings us to the final area, back here, where we will now collect the four key items.
What's the pace right now?
What do you mean? Oh, how good the pace is?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not running this very often. But
I appreciate your proficiency.
I know. I think there's still a bat left, isn't there? Maybe not. Let's try without. So in front of these... So these are the statues we need to collect for the final level. But in front of them, there are triggers, which I want to avoid by jumping through the corner. Like this.
Sounds illegal to me.
Maybe. I'm not the judge here.
At speed police. We need your advice. Eraser a une question.
Posez la question. Sorry.
No, like, this, no. Did you even clip through the corner there?
Yes,
okay.
Because if I had not, then there would be spikes coming down from the top and the entry there would have been shut down.
Okay, fair enough.
Which it evidently has not. So with those four key items, we may now return to the start, where we'll go out and should be on our way to the end, I hope. What could go wrong?
I quickly want to address that point. So of course we could have added more games. There's just one kind of limiting factor here, and that's called taking a plane back.
I'm sorry for actually having to work. So now I should be able to ignore those bats. Maybe I'll still safety save here. Because, as I said, if I'm out of bounds, other entities can interact with triggers, including the one at the door there. Oh, that's bad. Oh no, I should not have reloaded. Well, rip. Whatever. Guess I just have to hope they don't go through the exit. Can you stop being here? No! I think they triggered it at the very end. Oops. Guess I have to kill some bats. So, what was that question about how I think about bats in this game?
Can answer this next question. Is it worth flying from Munich to Zurich?
Yes.
Okay.
Especially if you have a discount on flight tickets, but who would have such a thing?
To be fair, there's a direct train connection between the cities, and it's like, what, 4.5 hours or so?
It's too much.
It's surprisingly long, actually. I wouldn't have thought so either, but
where is
Switzerland
flight?
Is quite far west, I think.
How many bats are there? Please stop. Thank you.
7.
Next try, I guess. Also, the pace of this run is really bad. Next try. Amazing.
I hope I emulate a full audience quite well. Hope this is to your liking.
So here I also may trigger the wrong cutscene, which would be rather bad. This does not look good. Also, please look away for like 3 seconds and don't listen. Oops, it's okay, you can watch again.
Thank what you. Happened?
I don't know.
I didn't see anything.
Oops. What?
Is there anything worth mentioning or?
I think it's worth mentioning that the grenade launcher is a pretty cool weapon.
I'm sorry. Did you just do what I think I saw you doing?
What?
Animal cruelty.
Well, no. Okay. They were possessed, so I just helped them not being possessed anymore, I guess.
That's a quite drastic way of doing so, but I guess that works, yeah.
Okay. Hello. Thank you. So you saw me collect a water bag there, which we will need for the final puzzle. What is happening?
Yes, kill the animals, one. Thanks for donating, everybody.
Oops.
Are you proud of yourself and your actions? I'm curious.
Looking at the pace of this run, no, in fact, I'm not.
What's your PB again? 54 or?
What? Excuse me, that's Tom 5.
I'm just, okay, sorry.
59, a high 59.
Okay. RTA that is, I assume?
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry for not PBing.
So the first world record of Tokyo Thorn can still happen.
No, it has
in the next run. First actual world record.
What?
There is no IL board for Max Payne. Sorry.
So we're approaching the final level. I'm not that bad with pace, but what was my estimate? I don't even
think 105.
105? No. Wasn't it 105 originally? I don't know.
105 plus 5 minutes of setup time.
I don't know.
Yeah, but
I mean, it's not even my estimate, it was just given to me, so. Just saying.
Yeah, of course, we could have added game name and estimate and everything. Like, could have integrated that into the stream layout, but why? It's like effort.
What would be a good run in this game? Anything but my run.
Yeah, what's world record? 57?
56 something. Six. By at Footy. Who, by the way, is verified by now. Just wanted to point that out. So here we are in the final level. It's the Great Pyramid of Gizeh, of course.
I'd kindly ask the audience to be quiet. The runner can focus here.
Well, soon I will have to. There we go, 56:46. Which is like 2 minutes ahead of everybody else. I wonder if Footy is really good at this game. But yeah. So I collect a second water bag here, because I will now have to do the final puzzle. As you can see, there is a scale on the other side of the room. And you only have water bags which can take 5 and 3 liters, and you need, for the first one you need to fill in 2 liters, for the second one you need to fill in 4 liters, and for the final one you need to fill in 1 liter. So this is a very fun puzzle, I guess. I also should have checked my flare count, I guess, because I know I actually wasted some. Let me just do that now. 15, okay, never mind. I actually, this would also be something to be on my notes, but since it's not, oops. No, what am I doing?
This puzzle seems rather difficult, actually, given your performance.
Good thing I was able to convey that.
No.
Stop saying no, love. No. It's not that bad. That should be 4 liters. I will go overestimate. Apparently, but as I said, I didn't even know my estimate. So it's not my estimate.
I mean, it kind of is, because the original estimate was 1 hour.
Which may be a bit tight for a 59-52 PB.
And you said maybe we should make it 105. I was like, okay, let's make it 105.
I see. But luckily, you were very fast with your run, so we'll just add that to my estimate. So this is the final one, and now I just need to go down to the bottom of this temple, for which I may have a faster way than actually climbing down, which may or may not involve a flare.
Well, to be fair, the schedule could have 5 games, if Underworld is a bonus run, just, you know, pointing out this possibility.
No. So much for that. I mean, what? No.
Just saying, the game is installed,
but
on this PC,
not running in Windows mode yet.
We can make this happen easily.
God damn. So these are the 4 items we collected that we need, because cutscene and stuff, and then. Because this is a classic Tomb Raider, you traditionally always don't really fight a boss at the very end, you have to escape. So after this will be the escape sequence. Hello at Drunken Shoe. Fun fact, actually, in French, there is a separate French dub. So she would have said non. And here, this makes sense.
What?
So by re-grabbing that ledge, you teleport upwards. And that's because of some very favorable alignment of geometries, which I think, from my knowledge, is only present exactly there. So, yay. Yes, indeed, French has its own dub. But I went with German for this one because Germany, I guess.
I think you want to say Bavaria, but botched up the word.
Well, if I had said Bavaria, then maybe at Sphere MJ or someone else would have corrected me and said the different, the opposite. So, you know. Nice. That's why I saved there. Stop knocking me, please. Okay, Footy can confirm that this is in fact the only instance where geometry is aligned like this. And here at the top you're such as supposed to climb out, so the chamber down here closes and the evil god is sealed forever. But that would trigger a cutscene, so if you climb out at the very edge here, the cutscene doesn't play. So I guess we don't save the world, the evil god is not sealed, but whatever.
That's fine.
I know, I need to go fast, kinda. So what was the split key again?
Number 7.
Yes. Not that I would ever fail anything this late in the run. Hint.
Anything you want to say with that, or...?
No.
Okay.
I've gotten over it at this point. And that would be, then, I guess, time. What an amazing run. I want to thank the schedule team for actually accepting this. My 2nd ever Tom 4 run in a marathon. Amazing. Already quitting out, thank you.
Yeah. No, just pointing out, if you haven't seen it yet, this is what you get.
Oh no. I'm sorry. But yeah, that was Tomb 4. I think up next, Toka wants to show us an even better game. Which there may or may not have been some development with yesterday.
I hope
so. Which you may or may not want to disclose. But that's up to you.
I guess.
Oh yeah.
Hello, my name is David Hasselhoff.
I'm not Kit.
Welcome to my game. Anyways, I hope you're ready for Knight Rider 2.
I am.
And let's start. Okay, so for the start of this run, we hold two buttons. How are you doing?
I am very sad after my performance just now.
It was a rather nice performance.
Thank you.
I enjoyed it.
I enjoyed the line.
What? yeah, so as I said, for the first 45 seconds, this is exactly what we do. Due to this technique, we're making use of called bunny hopping. Because the more you jump, the more you buffer jump,
the faster you go, as you see here. An absolutely insane jump. I got there. And yeah, so aside from the cutscenes at the start and the end of every level, we can skip them all, which of course comes in quite in handy.
I would imagine.
Would you? Why is that?
Game sounds a little loud.
Oh, it is. I'm very sorry. World record is dead. And so am I. Okay, I'll go. Oh.
This is not incorrect. Oh. Okay.
So yeah, this is Knight Rider 2. Welcome to the room.
Who are you again?
My name is David Hasselhoff. Yeah, so what you saw, there's a feature called reset position, which is quite useful in a few places, sadly not in the first mission. Because as you see, the goal is to kind of, you know, drive away from these missiles. And resetting your position and staying in place is maybe not the most helpful thing here. But at least we can enjoy start this mission again. I'm so hyped.
And you also already heard the mission failed thing, I guess. Which may or may not have been different yesterday. I don't know.
Not sure what you're talking about, really.
It just came to mind.
The only thing I'll say is that the sound files for this game are WAV files.
That's it.
Which can or cannot be modified.
Or replaced.
In any way, of course. There may or may not be an idea for a SpeedCon donation incentive. But I'm not sure. Anyway. So this is the first level out of 11, I think. Not sure. But in this level we learn how to play the game. Namely how to drive, how to jump, obviously. This is essentially a jump and run game, you know?
I have actually not checked. Oh, I should also probably adjust the game. Is there...
That's optional. Yeah, there. Yeah, those are the kind of cutscenes I was talking about. You can skip, which are inside, or within the mission, rather. And if you press the backspace key at a good time, they will not play out. Which is nice. The one drawback of that is that if you press the backspace too early, the menu will open, because that's the second, oh my god, function of that, of the said key. So you gotta be rather careful with these kind of things. Maybe.
I also sadly have to say that the only automated attack for Knight Rider 2 the game is driving racing.
Okay. I mean, it's not the full truth, but at least it's not too far away from it either. Okay. Also, what I can also say is that there now is a skip for mission 5. It's not totally legit, but it works. If the donation incentive is met, I can show that off after this run.
Please sub to me.
What?
Or any other ways of donation.
No, I can not. I'm sorry. I can do that after this mission ends, because then I can go out of the game. Well, yeah, maybe he is mumbling, that's true. Could be.
I'm not listening to myself most of the time, so I can't.
Maybe now it's better. Maybe so. To be fair, the game is actually pretty loud. Although the default settings of the game are 70%, and I turned the game down in the Windows settings to like 13%, and this is the volume you get. And when you first start the game, it's of course is at 100%, so take that as you
nice
want.
Price. So now we're seeing some cool tricks.
Yes. You drive on two wheels, which is an absolutely flawless feature, which has never failed me so far, ever. But of course, we'd rather
bunny hop
game, so let's do that.
Luckily, the first mission is almost over. We're only being introduced to the last feature we'll encounter, at least for now, which is called the Super Pursuit mode. And you see, we're going very fast. We're going at precisely 313 miles per hour. Which is like, I think, 500 kilometers per hour or 1000 D-Mark. If I may convert that in this way. So now I can actually fix things.
That was close.
I believe that was the last one, Michael.
Hey, buddy, why don't you scan what's left of that missile for clues while I talk to Devin?
Yes, Michael.
Michael, what a surprise. How are you?
I've been better. Or
somebody just tried to shoot missiles at us.
I have some flashbacks.
What are you telling me?
We were just driving on this deserted road, and then out of the blue, these missiles show up. Kid is now scanning the debris for clues. Maybe Bonnie can look over the results and find out who's behind this.
Sounds very suspicious.
Listen,
don't drive to the foundation.
I'll send Bonnie in your direction with the semi. You'll rendezvous halfway.
And Caddy?
Yes, Devin.
Be careful out there.
Well,
Kit, you heard the man.
Yes.
Let's get out of these mountains and find
I was just naming a famous football player.
Okay, that's interesting to say the least. Okay, so now that we're out of the tutorial level, we can actually play the game and have fun, I guess. So you will make use of the Super Pursuit mode while we're not actually going at 313 miles per hour, but it's rather, what is it, 170, 180? I should actually rewatch the video I made on that. Which I solely made just so I remember eventually how fast this goes. But it actually is substantially faster than the usual driving speed. And the difference they added up by changing the field of view from like 60 to 110 or so is what I gathered from the game settings text files. Yes, you can modify the text file on the skip.
And yes, there are some skips
yeah.
in this game.
So gates are optional.
Hey, watch the paint!
Mission completed.
That's pretty good, yeah. I like that. Do you know what happened there, precisely?
No.
Oh, that's a shame. In that case, I should explain that. Or at least try to explain, because I'm not fully sure what happens, but I have a rough idea at least. So before that gate, there's a cutscene, and what you can do with a cutscene, if it's within a level, as you know, you can skip it. And if it seems that if you go into the cutscene at just enough speed, and you skip the cutscene very quickly, what you'll get is... what you'll get is some kind of difference between your texture and your hitbox, or rather Kid's texture and Kid's hitbox. So it seems like the hitbox is in front of the texture, so if you drive up to the gate, you physically hit the... Are you trying to distract me?
No!
You literally are! But like, what?
I will see myself out now. Bye.
Stop.
Kicked out.
As I was about to say, luckily I did not lose my train of thought here, although that was your intention. The hitbox seems to be behind the gate. You hit the trigger, and when you reset position, that's the closest one. So you spawn behind the gate, that's kind of the idea, from what I gathered.
I see.
Glad I could enlighten you.
So, how active is the Knight Rider 2 speedrunning community?
You all right, old buddy?
Well, depends on how you define active. So, if a run is active, if it's happened within the last 3 years, then quite active, I would say.
Otherwise, we might have to rediscuss this the finish.
Let's see.
That was close. Let's get back to the semi.
Okay.
Where did I find a gem like this? Shoutouts to my childhood, I guess. I remember we were in some kind of secondhand game shop, not GameStop, but actually something way more underground. And I thought this game looked cool, so I purchased it. Or I had my mom purchase it for me. That's why I'm here now. I'm not saying I like it, but that's just how it is. So as you see, fighting this game is fun. Should maybe elaborate on that a bit more actually. So we have three weapons in this game. Blip robot, I'm sorry. We have three weapons in this game. We have the missiles you already saw, which are not really useful in actual combat, but rather if there's some, I don't know, some tower to destroy or something relevant for the mission or rather level geometry. And then you have the actual near-range weapons, which is the laser gun, which is rather weak, and the plasma gun. Ah, come on, that could have two other guns. And the plasma gun,
which makes sounds similar to pew. Just pointing that out.
Not sure where I got that thought, but you're not incorrect. Put it like that. Anyways, the plasma gun doesn't have a cap on how fast you can shoot, which is very nice, because the faster you can spam num5, and no, this is not Prince of Persia, the faster you shoot in this game. Okay, so for this mission we have to activate three switches, I guess, or terminals, or however you want to call it. And we do that by scanning them for precisely 10 seconds, which is very action-packed. Trust me.
Steady, please, Michael. Steady.
I'm sorry.
Michael.
What?
What?
I'm not sure what's up with you now. So yes, you see this. As I said before, there's no cap on the plasma gun. That, of course, a single plasma gun shot is not too powerful, but frequency really makes up for it. It's kind of like the dual Ingram, or why the dual Ingram is advantageous over everything else. I'm doing this on purpose. This is, I'm absolutely assured, this is mocking.
No.
You're mocking me purposely.
I shall not convey any kind of acceptance or confirmation anymore. I'm sorry.
You may do so if it's
enjoy
not-
enjoy your silence.
If it's not as sarcastic as
what?
All the time. It's literally what's going on. Anyways, this is mission 5, the mission I'll show off a new skip for after this run. But for now, we'll do it normally, sadly. At Havard. Who's not in chat right now, but that's okay. So these lasers are actually, should be avoided rather carefully, put it like that. Because even touching them slightly, at least in this level, gives you a lot of damage, which you don't want.
Unless for testing purposes you want to hear the mission failed scream.
Of course.
Not sure. Why would you ever
yeah,
do that?
There's like literally no reason to do so. But especially there are 6 lasers crossing at the same time if they're in the wrong position. If you drive through, like 60% of health are gone within a split second, so should rather try to avoid that, maybe. Imagine SPM, but you're using it indoors. It's like riding a bike indoors at Pokemon. Also, I see the word alarm in chat. I leave.
do not need to worry about anything.
Could you explain me the origin of that meme?
Surely there is a more.
I'm totally in the dark.
Rather not, because I want to keep my channel.
Okay.
Thank you.
That's far enough. Anyways, so we deactivated this gate finally, which we could have gone through from the start. Problem is, it kind of kills you instantly. If you play legitimately, of course. But that's for another time. So we had to waste like 1.5 minutes to activate it, but now we're here. We are here. We activate this terminal. Then we can finish this mission by the end of the final fight. Flawlessly, of course, as you see now. There will be no enemy trolling whatsoever.
Let's get him!
Called it.
Oh my god.
Well done.
Stop. Are you sure about your previous statement?
Could get him, because in these cutscenes the enemies stop for a split second and then they go at the full speed again. That makes sense. As you might have guessed, the small enemies are the worst because they are quite fast. And what they're trying to do is they drive around you all the time, so it's essentially impossible to hit them. Hence why those are the troll enemies. And the larger ones are not as annoying, so that's fine. Every time I hear the sound, I want to split, but I don't have splits right now, so... If the timer at some point stops, please tell me. Then it was my fault.
But I'm sure it will not happen, because I trust you.
For I never make mistakes, ever. Oh my god, I take that back right now. As I told you, the lasers in the last level were quite deadly, and these do like no damage. As you see in a second, I'll just drive through them, because why not? Oops. That was a lot of damage. So my theory for this is there's a boss fight at the end, which if you do it for the first or second time, will drain a lot of your health. So they were like, we gotta weaken those lasers, else nobody will make it through this mission. And they were correct, because nobody played this game, but that's a whole different story. That's not the reason I was hinting at.
Better avoid the next one. We must find a power generator to charge my power packs. Warning, energy low.
Don't do it. Don't do it.
Warning, energy
I think I will
low.
Die. Which is not so fun. So, if you're lucky, you could one-cycle them. Sadly, I was not lucky. There's no gap in skill or anything, it's luck. It's pure luck. It's actually, well, it's not pure luck, but there is some luck to it, let's put it like that. Mainly because the focusing of your missiles don't work that well. Let's put it like that. Well, that's fine.
At 7 Eraser 7 wants to point out that luck is a skill.
Yeah. At all the Pokemon runners. I'm sorry. If you've had the, I would say my consistency of getting the one cycle is like 70% or so. It's like, okay, but it failed. It can fail occasionally.
What is this German in my chat? At.
Sorry, my mind blanked for a second. Did you say anything? Okay, this is mission 7, I think, which is one of the longer missions. Because here we'll have to do a lot of fighting, which we luckily can speed up a bit by parallelizing some tasks we have to do later on.
All right.
If we actually go too early onto this ramp, we'll get a cutscene in which you die, so...
What?
It's not like there's a bit of damage you take, but it's
all
an instant death. Yeah.
I see.
Hence why you have to wait
until the missiles destroy the laser gun, and then you can go. Can I stop? Oh my. Also, this is the only mission where you can skip the cutscene of enemies entering the scene, which comes rather in handy, especially because there will be a lot of fighting later on. So. It doesn't really speed up anything because you can't damage enemies like until their animation of entering the area ends, but you can already position yourself in a rather advantageous way. Just so you only have to mash your plasma gun, then they all die at once. Also, whoever fails the mission at this passage should leave the room right now. I have never failed. Ever. Anyways. So this is another call for our missile. Oops,
of course.
And for a frame there, or one or two frames, the screen turned blue when I skipped the cutscene. Not quite sure what's going on there. I think I'm faster than the game's loading, but that's okay. Nothing wrong there.
Let's get him!
Where are all those robots coming from?
Yeah, as I said before, the scheduling team apparently didn't think that POP was a good choice for this marathon. Although I submitted like 5 Prince of Persia games.
But we're not responsible for that.
Yeah. Blame the scheduling team, not us.
We can relay the complaints to the scheduling team.
Yes.
We
will, in fact, do so. So speaking of parallelizing, one thing you can do here is charge... Well, first of all, you can charge multiple missiles at once, which I didn't know for the first, like, 2 years I was, running this game. Lamo.
You all right, old buddy?
And so you can charge them and
not too bad.
Shoot them eventually, like whenever you like. Or whenever your crossbar targets the enemy. Or the object, rather, you want to destroy.
Where are all those robots coming from?
So yeah, in every of these areas there are 2 waves of enemies, on every side, every gate rather.
Let's get them.
And all that matters for speed is how quickly the second wave diminishes.
Oh no, more robots.
The spawning of the second wave is on a timer.
Must be careful, Michael.
But everything after that determines on how quickly you destroy them. Also, you can do some things also in a parallel way, such as scanning the terminal and shooting missiles. Where the terminal scan takes longer, so that should be prioritized. Then you can shoot the missile. Okay. Ah, come on. You really want to get rid of that laser cannon before you kill them. So these laser cannons don't hurt you too much, and certainly not instantly, but you don't want to be exposed to the laser beam for too long.
Where are all those robots coming from?
It does, yeah. Oh, yeah. Very nice. So. Enemies control you a lot because they don't, like geometrically, they don't line up like the other ones. If you want them to be in line so you can shoot them all at once, you have to be out of bounds. That's just mathematics. I'm sorry.
And I have learned quite a few things when it comes to mathematics during this stage.
Oh, have you?
Sure.
Have you ever heard of the Cayley-Hamilton theorem?
I in fact have.
Oh, yes. That's nice. That was the
mission. What I used to do there, actually, I did that right from the start, so I never really thought about it until recently. So I first killed all the enemies with a laser gun, so you're not in range for, like, not in range of the laser towers. Yes, and then at the very end, you destroy the laser towers, because you can only activate a terminal if you're not getting damaged during the whole 10-second period or whatever. I think it's close to 7 seconds, but anyway.
But when you turn your head,
and of course, insane, I know. It makes sense to kind of parallelize that so it goes a bit faster.
Sphere MJ, I think, wants to hear more about the Kelly Hamilton theorem. Mission completed. Go ahead.
Okay, so the statement is, if we insert any matrix, any finite matrix inside its characteristical polynomial, it's zero. So every matrix divides its own characteristical polynomial.
I think it even says every square.
Every square. I'm sorry.
Not too bad.
Otherwise, that doesn't make sense anyway.
That's just wanted to show that I actually read something.
Yeah, of course
at
you know that.
Wikipedia.
Okay. So what's happening right now is very good, because in the first phase of this fight, you have to destroy kind of the battery or whatever is like the generator of his shield, Garth's shield.
No.
And you can, as you can see here, he trolls you quite a lot. So the best thing is if he gets stuck at some kind of wall or whatever, so a laser beam can hit him constantly. Also, the laser beam is indeed the only way of shooting him when his shield is active, like even this battery pack. And for the second phase now that is deactivated, we can just use the plasma gun and bring him down. Okay. I was rather slow, but that's okay. Because I am slow. Oh
no.
I am, in fact, slow. Sorry about that.
Kit, any sign of Garth?
Negative, Michael. There is no one inside.
I'd say it's quite tricky to adjust your camera.
Correct.
Depending on the
reference.
Manually opened the gate. The footprints in the sand match those of Garth.
Do you see that on the ground, Kit?
Okay, upcoming is actually the most difficult skip of this game. Before. It's not too surprising, because there are two skips in this game. One of them is absolutely free. Second one is this one, but this can or might take several attempts, but it also saves like, what, 7 minutes? Five? I'm not even sure. It saves a lot, so it's absolutely worth doing. Everything from here on is still intended. You're intended to go up here, then they want you to go to the other side and enter a fighting area, but I suck. So we'll try that again.
At 7 erasers, 7. Just say.
I'm not sure what he said, but...
if you don't get the skip first try, you'll pay sushi to me at SpeedCon.
No. I won't and never agree to this, what the fuck? So easy, like
first try.
Easiest skip. But I mean, it's not over. If I fall down, I'll have to restart the mission. And it's still not over. It's only over after I actually finish this mission. But it's looking good. The hardest part is actually getting that jump, because there's this weird roof collision, which is actually not a triangle but has some flat surface which you want to jump off. And the problem is that you can't jump out of the super pursuit mode, which you need to gain enough speed. But the turbo boost has some kind of cooldown before it can start. And that's the finicky part. You really have to time everything precisely, because the flat surface of the roof is not too wide anyways. And but we made it. Second try. Second try is actually pretty good.
So does that mean free sushi for 7 Eraser 7 or
no?
There you have it.
It wouldn't even be for him, like, Eraser owes one stage sushi, so it would just be, you know, redistributing debts.
You saved my life.
No.
Anytime.
I won't stand for this.
Of course, Mike.
Mission completed.
Completely unrelated to anything.
Yeah, just I like the song. Okay, anyways, that was an actually pretty difficult skip, and no, I lied, there's actually three skips in the game, sorry. There's only a skip we do in this mission.
Yeah!
And we'll skip two enemy waves. So there usually are seven enemy waves here, but we'll proceed after the fifth one. We can proceed after the third one, but that's an insanely tight window. I only got it in my segmented run, and I only got it ever like twice. I don't think that's feasible for RTA. That's just my unimportant opinion. Sorry.
I don't think I can provide a different opinion.
Yet. All robots are heading our way.
Did you just say yet?
Just saying 12-hour challenge next week.
Okay. Of course it's not forbidden to learn more than one game within these 12 hours. And of course you're correct. So now we're after the fifth wave. There's just enough time to activate the terminal here. So this big laser beam is very scary, but it does like no damage or whatever. All you have to do here is shoot missiles all the time. Luckily, this cutscene does not interrupt your missile charging, because it's a skippable cutscene. Although that's not entirely true, so some skippable cutscenes make you uncharge your missiles, but this one luckily doesn't, so that's nice. That was mission 10. I think this skip saves like 20 seconds or so, because in the last two waves there are a lot of big enemies. You need a lot of plasma gun shots to destroy them.
Mission completed.
That went rather nicely. Now we can go on and do the final mission of the game, for which I want to point out I do not have the IL world record for this. Because at some point a random German guy came up and sniped my IL record by 1 second. It's now 51 seconds by Prünke, or however, whatever his name is, I don't remember. I also don't want to. I don't understand his modus at all. That's the only thing he has ever done for the game. The only IL or full game run. And I have no idea why, but that's fine.
So I suggest instead of Underworld as bonus game, we should do IL grind this mission.
No, thanks.
Okay, I tried.
That was too close.
Okay, what you can do in this mission, you can kind of manipulate his movement by going left and right. Like, it depends on the angle your laser targets him at.
Stop it. You have no right.
Okay, so, time, by the way, sorry. Not sure what I did at the end, but... that's fine. So, car die. And mustache Michael Knight also dies. That's fine.
I am sorry, Michael. The intense heat prevented me from getting a lock on.
Is Kit on fire?
I guess.
Is this an homage?
No. I hope not. Because whatever it would be a homage to, it would not be deserved for
that game. Oh, that's a shame.
We don't have enough time to get up there.
But I appreciate it.
Why don't we try to blow up the computer?
Anyways, this was Baywatch the game. Oh wait. Correct actor, wrong show. So we destroy the tower and we get out of here. And that's essentially the final cutscene. Aside from a few interesting dialogues maybe. That's the core content you're seeing here.
Let's get out of here, buddy.
Warning, 3 exclamation marks. It's rather imminent, it's actually, yeah. Yes. Check Discord. Eraser, I will after this run. During the intermission screen, I can...
Congratulations, Michael. And you too, Kit.
Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Miles.
Some days, everything goes as planned.
Oh, Michael. You're the living proof that one
can make a difference.
One man
and his car. Who is this Bonnie person that was just mentioned?
I'm not sure.
Let's
Shall I enable auto cruise?
You got it. Almost like we skipped all cutscenes where Bonnie appears. Not sure.
Michael Knight, a lone crusader in a dangerous world. The world
of the Knight Rider.
Mission
abgeschlossen. Anyways, thank you. This was this was my last run of the marathon. I hope you'll enjoy Tomb Raider Underworld. No. Oh wait.
What?
I mean Angel of Dumbass, Darkness.
What?
a sequel.
Yeah, I mean, Ollie looks good. So
yes. I mean, what?
Yes.
So, I don't know, maybe you can tell us if the game is too loud or too low on volume again.
It looked like, in OS, it looks okay. Maybe. Not sure. Angle of dankness. Also like that.
I'm undecided. Game is louder than Umaru, so it's not good. I do not agree. Sorry.
Whatever.
But I guess that
I just
means
started the run.
Okay. Exactly.
You have quick save anyways, don't you?
What? But yeah, I guess I'll just start then. Yeah, let's do that. No. But yeah, so this is Angel of Darkness, this is Tomb Raider 6. It's a very good game, as you can see, with literally no flaws, and it was very well received and is still among the favorites of any Tomb Raider runner. Because this does not work. Stop. There we go. So yeah, as you can see, some things may not work as intended. I'm not sure. So you saw a few things there you will re-encounter quite often. So the first one was that I crouched through a door. So there is quick save, quick load in this game. And if you quick save at the correct timing, while Lara is starting to lean forwards after crouching down, and you reload that save, you will clip through doors or walls, and that can be very helpful because we accessed a part of the level we were not supposed to access, of course. Then the other thing you will see more often is the same thing we will do here, which is jump into walls and then hit triggers, because
an
good
evil
game.
Night to be out alone,
and then please ignore whatever is happening here. So this is the only conversation we have in this run. There are actually more in the entire game because they try to go RPG.
Dead?
Can I get you anything?
So yeah, they try to add some RPG elements, I guess.
I arrived at his apartment today from London.
And this is what it turned out into.
He said he tried to contact you.
He did.
So in this conversation, you can give her bad or good answers. And if you give her more than two bad answers, she will just walk away without giving us Werner's notebook, who may or may not be the same Werner from Tomb Raider 4.
The clan's name was the game like over if she does that?
No. If you, she does not give you the notebook, you have to collect it yourself by going into the kitchen, which of course is slower than getting it from her. So what I will do is I will always give her the nice answers except for the very last option, because there we still have one bad answer we can give, and it saves the most time since we skip some dialogue there. If we're rude. And as you can tell, this is in English, and there's actually a good reason for this.
Yeah, I thought it was in French.
That's why I'm Mademoiselle. That's why I'm trying to clear this up.
Oh, thanks.
So there is actually a good reason for it in this game, because for any percent, which is the version I'm running, English is the fastest, because conversation length actually depends on the voice lines, and it just so happens that English has the fastest voice lines, which are not Japanese, because Japanese is actually faster also for this conversation.
I didn't kill him.
But
I didn't.
Japanese version is only available in version 52, which does not have some techniques we will use in this run. So English is the fastest version, which also has version 49. So that was this.
Never killed Werner.
Out of all the times Werner was killed, she never killed Werner. Yeah. Yes.
Glad this is cleared up.
So now that we have the notebook, we can leave. And we're now in a abandoned Parisian train, which we will leave by jumping into the wall, I guess. Because then we're in the Parisian ghetto, which is very well known.
Yeah. And actually, when I was in Paris, I was there as well. I clearly remember all, you know, all these streets and everything.
I also hope you remember the lady in red, which may or may not be part of the adult entertainment industry to the left there. And what I actually want to do is, since I'm in Paris, I want to visit the Louvre Museum.
which we all know can be accessed by entering a random pawn shop and then jumping into the wall, which will first bring you to the Parisian sewer system. And in that Parisian sewer system, you jump into another wall, which brings you into the actual Louvre. If the game loads.
It's exactly my experience, really. So, yeah.
There we go.
Well,
interesting load time. At least it's clean in here.
This game is on SSD, by the way. I'm just pointing that out.
And here we actually cannot do these trigger bugs, and I will actually do a safety. That is a bad idea to safety save in a quick save slot. So maybe let's not do that. Because what I want to do here is I want to do another one of those crouch saves, which may or may not work with this guy pushing me around. It did not work. Because I also, to be fair, saved rather late. And this may again be late. But what I want to do is I want to crouch through this wall and then bypass the next area out of bounds. Can you stop tasing me when I'm out of bounds? You're not supposed to see me. So here we are out of bounds, and we can now bypass this room with lasers over here. Which is already nice because that saves us some time, but it also means we can ignore the rest of this level, kind of. So as you can see, past this point, textures are basically not loaded, which of course is not all that helpful because it makes orienting yourself a bit difficult. And now I need to descend a set of stairs while I don't see the stairs, which also is a bit difficult, I guess.
Actually, I think I remember that laser room from Max Payne GBA.
You may not want to dive through the lasers in this game.
That's a shame.
Because we also don't have painkillers. But yeah, so at the bottom of the Louvre, I think this is rather accurate. There is actually a huge archaeological digging site, which we will enter now. And apparently there is some stuff going on, but I wouldn't know because we're leaving again by jumping into a wall. And now people are mad at us, so we have to escape the Louvre. And that's actually almost, that almost brings our Paris visit to an end. Sorry at 7 Eraser 7.
On ne bouge plus!
Excusez-nous!
Sadly, I don't really speak French, so I'm sure he did not say that I should not move. But yeah, this gets us out of the Louvre, and now we're visiting the apartment of some Werner von Croy, which I'm not sure who he is. Nice loading times, by the way.
Are you okay?
No.
SSD, by the way.
So in this level, you will fight a boss called the Cleaner, and it's kind of a boss fight over multiple stages.
My legs feel stronger.
Also, Lara's legs feel stronger because I kicked in a door. Don't question
me. I mean, evidently, yeah.
Yes. And I also like to read books from time to time by crouching into them. But this time, okay, there we go. So this bypasses a set of lasers. But yeah, so basically the boss fight in this stage is, in this level is supposed to have multiple stages. But with our techniques, we may bypass the majority of them and skip straight to the end. In this room, we also have a rather strong weapon, which I will pick up. So this is the Viper machine gun. You can also collect Werner's handgun in the very first room, and it's actually a pretty safe option, but it also does a lot less damage. However, you don't have to do all these crouch saves, which I'm very proficient at, as you can see. This is normal, trust me. And then we go back inbounds over here. And I should probably equip the weapon, I don't know. And then ignore these lasers, and there is the boss, which brings us to a very complex boss fight, which includes holding down the action. So this is where the pistol route would lose out quite a bit, because it obviously takes longer with a pistol. Which brings us to a level where I kind of want to create another save state, because it may or may not be historically evident that there are some self-clocks in this level. I don't know.
Open.
But yeah, here we need to meet up with a... that was not good, so I assume this will not work. Yeah, I thought so. That's why I saved. We need to meet up with a Czech journalist here. And well,
is it Grimmer's son?
No.
Oh, it's right.
Open. Though it may be an homage.
Okay.
Yeah. It won't open. So again, some black magic. Oh, here we are. Hi.
Have you changed your mind? Which brings about us the to this Hobco?
Conversation.
Yes, I
which,
thought I'd give you another
with the route
chance.
I took, may but have or should have lower chance of soft blocking, but it also
it's
has
deal,
soft block
Luddick.
Using this route.
This passcode will get
but yeah,
you
this
into the
one has
area.
Historically always soft blocked,
pass,
and what will happen is
the
that the same line will be repeated over and over again, and you cannot access the menu or anything, so all you can do is force quit the game.
Workers have gone missing and all kinds of spooky stuff.
What
and
goes on in there?
Just being in this
God
conversation
Lord, I'd give my
feels wrong
to, find out,
to me because in the actual 80% route,
for me. If
with,
you
which
anything,
reloads,
give me first shot
removes load
it,
times,
sure thing.
We completely skip this
car.
Conversation.
The Strahov isn't far.
But it worked out, I guess. Thank you. So now we are in fact in the Strahov, which in this game is the base of the evil organization. In real life, in fact, is a quarter of Prague, which I have been to, and I can tell this is exactly what it looks like. Also, this is really bad. Can you please clip through? Why are people sad that Ludwig did not suffer? This is bullying.
This is not the goal of speedrunning. Let me point that out.
Yeah, there is a double set of gates there, which I bypassed by crouching through them. And now we need to get past some lasers. And by getting past, I mean I will walk through them. Because first here I will do what we call a leg break. So now Lara's leg will extend pretty much across the entire map. Which can, like, if the map leg is invisible there, that's how you see it work. So what I do now is I pick up an item. Since my leg extends across the entire stage, I'm basically near any one of those. And during pickup animation, no damage will be inflicted upon you.
Thanks, by the way, for the raid at Jazz Runs.
Thank you from my side as well. Don't question what is happening here. And yeah, I need to get up here to trigger a guard, which has the key card that I need. And I saved in midair there, because that lets you retain some of your momentum, which we call moon jumping, so it allows you to extend your jump range rather drastically. And with that keycard obtained, I can now access this room, where I will be able to shut down the lasers preventing me to proceed to the next level. Also, you probably see me quite often in this weird screen asking me whether I want to quick out. What I do there is I go into the Alt F4 menu. If you cancel out of that, the game kind of forgets that there was a cutscene. So that's a good way to skip cutscenes, I guess. And yes, we are in fact in Prague, so there may be some Czech voice lines. But I don't think there are any past this point. But yeah, that is the Strahov. Now we go into the bio-research facility. On the left here, you can see there is a NPC, which if you talk to, you will be in a 5-minute conversation, so I choose not to. Instead, I want to proceed onwards, and I probably quick save too early. Yeah. But yeah, this should be standard by now. If I could get it, of course.
My PC's at fault, don't worry.
That's what I wanted to hear. Good. So yeah, this flyby we sadly cannot skip. But after this I will do a thing very similar to what I did in the Louvre, where I will again clip through the wall and the rest of the level will not be loaded. Luckily this time there is some water textures, which depending on the PC or on the game settings are more or less visible. I hope I configured them correctly. I don't know, we'll see. Otherwise, I'm a bit screwed, but you're screwed in the first place when you start this game. Katarev 2019. I almost picked up a medkit for no reason. Luckily I avoided that, but yeah, so here we just go down some corridors. There should be a stair here, exactly, and here you see the water texture. Nice.
Okay. Is that visible enough for you?
That is very visible, yes.
Nice.
And then we do another moon jump here to get on top of a clearly visible pipe. But first I will save. I'm worried for the final moon jump because I don't know the timing, but it's okay. It should work. This did not work. Good. But yeah, I'm now on top of the pipe and all I need to do is cross over the gap, which you also cannot see, but I crossed it now, good. And yeah, so this brings the Lara part of this game to somewhat of a hold for now, because there are actually two playable characters in this game. Almost.
Yeah, just want to just point out there may or may not be a bonus run after this. It's the game starting with Tomb Raider and then a U.
I'm a bit confused why I'm not getting the trigger button. There we go. So yeah, this brings Lara to an end, and now we play as Curtis, who may or may not have worse controls than Lara. I will not be the judge on that.
Please don't bully my boy Nathan Drake.
Oops.
So I guess that death was intended, or?
Yes, of course. This is all RNG manipulation, because at the end of Curtis' segment, there is a rather infamous boss, which I need very good RNG for. Can you please just end this? Why?
You're doing quite well, no
Stop.
Worries.
I just want to proceed. Why? I'm not even sure why I took more damage, apparently.
What exactly is supposed to happen here?
That I survive this jump down there.
Okay. How's that supposed to happen?
By just bonking into the wall and not dying when, like, dropping down.
Okay. So you have this too low, or? No.
That's what I wanted. Yeah, it should definitely not take that much. I don't know if I, like, took some extra damage, but ignore that. This is, by the way, plenty of health. Don't worry. And yeah, the one upside Curtis has is he just crouches and goes through walls and doors, other than Lara, who needs to quick save and quick load. So thank you for that, Core.
Is that the predecessor to Outlast, by the way?
Pardon?
If that's the predecessor to Outlast.
Well, since I'm not an Outlast runner, you may want to ask, for example, at Catalyst Z.
Okay.
Also some more deload stuff. Don't question this. I'm sure you're well aware of what's going on.
Yeah. I guess strictly it's not out of bounds.
Exactly.
That's
yes,
true.
That is the case, because he would have collision if I would not have just picked up something over long range, which makes me ignore collision. But yeah, you in fact still have collision and everything here, just no textures. And now I need to find an air vent where I need to pull myself up to trigger a cutscene that I need to get rid of. And then I can again look for a spot where I can bonk into the wall, and that should bring me to the next part of the level. I don't like this though. Okay, never mind. So this brings us to maximum containment area. There will be almost no glitches in this one, but what there will be is a very cool boss fight, I guess. So the thing is that experiments in here have created a... So what they're trying to do is they want to resurrect an extinct angel race of angels, basically. And yeah.
Obviously.
Obviously also, things may not have gone to plan. And yeah, so what we will fight is kind of an aborted result of those experiments. And it is single-handedly the biggest RNG thing in this run. In fact, so much so that this is basically the only thing that has any kind of variance left in the any percent runs. So that makes them very fun to grind, I guess. So this is the proto pile. And what this pipe consists of is basically it has four main phases. Whenever it comes down or spawns in, you shoot it. And then it first will be knocked down, except for the very first phase. And after you shoot it some more, it... Hi.
At Catalyst Z.
After you shoot some more, it will then go back into the air vents up there. And rinse and repeat. So, yeah. As you also can tell, great boss music. None.
Where's your grenade launcher now? You praised it so much earlier today.
Maybe AOD is not a classic after all. I'm sorry. New evidence. But yeah, so this was the second phase. Two more to go. Hope everybody is excited.
This is the fastest proto so far, or?
This is a pretty pace? Like, so far, not the best.
Okay.
Let's say it like this. Because in fact he has three spawn locations. One just above the sliver, and the other two are coming from either side of those bridges. And these two are slower spawns. So since both of the times he spawned from the bridge. Not too excited about this fight.
Shame.
But yeah, the biggest time save would actually be in the... in the end I need to pull that lever there, and you're only supposed to pull that in the final phase. He has first gone down and then you shoot him again. But for whatever reason, sometimes you just need to shoot him once in the final phase and he's already KO'd. But we still don't really know why that happens. But let's see if maybe the final spawn is close, but I think that is a pretty definitive no. I was correct, so good.
Okay, you might want to be aware that Catalyst Z is not happy with the lack of Tom 5 in this marathon.
Well, as we pointed out a few times, we're not part of the scheduling teams.
So. Yeah, that's correct. Of course, those games were all submitted.
But yeah, so this was the end of Curtis's part. I know, sad, but oh well. We're now going back to Lara, and immediately the difficulty picks up quite tremendously. So that was a very cool level. Which brings us to some swimming, because that has been missing so far. But don't worry, we will not swim for too long in an area we're supposed to, I guess.
That's not what I wanted to hear. The sentence started off nicely, but, you know, decayed eventually. I gotta say, those lungs of Lara are quite impressive. My opinion here.
In fact, there is actually no mechanic where you can level up her lungs, but you can level up her arms and her legs, where she will say that she feels stronger now.
Okay.
But lungs, I guess, they don't need training. So here we go out of bounds over here. And we should go back to swimming, but oh well. I guess this counts as swimming as well.
Is this Pop 3D?
This is, in fact, Donkey Kong 64.
Okay.
So yeah, now I just need to hit the level end trigger, which should show us Curtis for a short while. Hi, Curtis. Bye, Curtis. And that brings us to the second last level, but it will not take very long to do this one. Hopefully. I don't know. So first I'll open that gate, and then I will do some more moon jumps to make these next jumps. You're supposed to be on like the last upgrade of your legs here, which gives you like a far jump, I guess, but with moon jumps, we don't care about those silly things. And here, there is a trap in front of us, which I will try to avoid. I did it. Thank you. At least something went well. And yeah, so after this door opens, we're in the final level. Just one more set of traps, and then the final boss fight. Whatever that means.
What are these quotation marks again?
It's up
for a reoccurring theme.
It's up for interpretation. Okay. What defines a fight? So I let everyone be their own judge. Good gate. So here is the final boss fight. Don't worry about any Alt F4 or loading screens you will see. This is definitely what this fight is supposed to look like. And I'm also definitely not safety saving here. Amazing. Woo. Thank you. So yeah, they had a very good idea to just put the game end trigger at the top there, because you're actually supposed to fight the guy multiple stages and go all the way to the top and then jump down, but we guess we jumped up. So yeah, that was AOD.
Yeah, so the one thing I promised I didn't show off last run was the mission 5 skip, so I'll quickly do that.
Sure.
And afterwards, if Katariff wants, he can show off another game. That's up to him entirely. Also, I don't think we need an... Oh my god. I don't think we'll need an intermission screen for that. Because everything's set up already. Lucky. So this is the underground maze as before, and I'll have to do a very difficult trick now. I hope it worked. If it didn't, I'll have to try again. So I just want to show this is the gate which insta-kills you, as you see here, but we can maybe do something about that. Mission failed. Da 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 da.
Don't question this.
Okay. Okay, maybe I should listen to what's going on. Is it... Okay, this is too quiet, I have to kind of... Sorry. Oops.
Kit, keep your senses. I have a bad feeling about this place.
Of course, Michael.
Okay, we'll just... try it. I just want to show off. This thing insta-killed you, in case someone wasn't aware. As you see here, it still does. Fucking... Oh my god. Maybe?
This has been built recently, Michael.
This would be rather sad. It did work yesterday.
I can actually confirm.
Mission failed.
Fuck!
Please watch out what you're saying on my chat. Hello.
There's nothing happening, is there?
This has been built recently.
Anything else targeting the window, or am I, like, stupid? Fuck.
Keep your senses.
Anyways, guess I'm not showing this off. One second. Fuck. Oh my god. Cheatbook DE. Okay. Keep tweeting. That's what I. Fuck off. That's what I did. This. Okay. But I can. The problem is I can't play the game, so there has to be something which takes away my inputs. It did work with OBS yesterday, so that's not it. this doesn't work, I'll just show the video footage. Maybe it worked, maybe I was just too slow. That's fine. Video footage is ready. Oh!
Oh my God, I made it.
See, what I did, I activated an interesting glitch there. Where glitch is a rather fitting term, trust me. And then you just land here and can just finish the level by doing the fight.
Wait, yeah, so. Is this an actual run?
At Havert, we did it. We have a skip for mission 5.
Live for the first time.
That's actually, so what happened there? I yesterday learned quite a lot about this game. For example, that
more than probably one.
Also that, but also that there, like this game has cheat codes, and there are a few very strong cheat codes that, such as unlocking all quiz difficulties, which we can also do after this really quickly. But there's also a cheat for infinite health. It's, you do that by entering KIT on your keyboard, like K-I-T-T. During the cutscene, which plays at the start of a mission. So this is literally cheating. Very sorry, but this is how the mission would look like if we had a skip for this.
Sorry, at Twitch, it was not.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know, 1.5 minutes faster,
mission completed.
Something like that. It's not too much. This is how it would go. Anyway, let's skip. Of course, we could do the quiz on hard, but it's locked. Okay, it's a shame.
What?
Huh? Oh, can do the quiz on hard. Okay. Let's go, Twitch chat. What do you think is the right answer? Please enter it now. The highest number of song samples. Yeah, I mean that's something a true fan would know, of course. Like if we take as an example all the animes I've ever watched and I'm quite fond of. This is an easy question. I just know it, yeah? So, Eraser said C. It was wrong. It says, like, top right, yeah. It says how many correct answers there would be. Okay. Michael and Stevie's long love song. What? I have no idea what's going on. B is next. White Bird. Correct. Very nice.
Well done. Strive.
I Fail and Strive. You did it. Okay. Two actors appeared in the episode of Baywatch Nights. C, B, C, C wins. Okay, David Hasselhoff and William Daniels. Ah, it's wrong. Twitch said you suck.
Not looking good.
You suck so far. But that's fine. We also do. Okay, the original script for Knight Rider was written at what popular holiday destination? Oh, interesting. Of course, as a true fan, you just know that. Because I actually have the phone number of Glenn Larson. I could call him right now. That's how close we are. They're just, you know, it's easy. Weird check R. Sadly, that's not an option I can pick, but A is good. A is actually correct. Very nice. Strife and Jess. You win some Kataref stream points. Okay, where was Kid's gas tank inlet located? The hood? Trunk? Below the rear bumper? I mean, probably A, I don't know. That was probably for the last question, but I'll take it anyways. It's wrong. Sorry. Only 5 more questions. We're this close.
Hope you're
preparing Underworld already. Real life building used at the Foundation's headquarters. That, you know, the headquarters you don't even see in this game at all. Or in the last game. There's no game where you see the headquarters, but the bumper for sure was sadly wrong. No, under the hood was. Anyway. B. I don't know. A. Munich? Not an option. Strife says A. A is correct. Wow.
Strife.
You're pretty good. Strife, are actually a hardcore Knight Rider fan? Are we disclosing something here? Okay, 2 episodes feature the Sepulveda Dam. Of course. Obviously. Okay, then Los Angeles, California. Because of course, as a true fan for every show I ever watched, I know what episodes correlates to which title of the episode.
It's not like, oh yeah, that happened at the end of the show, no.
A lot of bees.
Episode...
Now I don't have the seas.
Episode 7, A Knight in a Shining Armor and A Knight in Disgrace. You know, also a very compact title, like...
It was wrong.
Sorry, guys. Okay. I think, like, if we get, like, 50%, I think we are average Nightrider fans. It would be okay. Which Nightrider star appeared in an episode of Star Trek, The Next Generation? Sphere, where are you? This is your question, dude. Patricia McPherson, Edward Muller, David Hasselhoff. It's Star Trek! Are you a true Star Trek fan or not? What the fuck, dude? B-A-C-B? Okay. C-A... Well, now it's 50% for everything. Okay. Let's take B. Oh my god. Fuck. The quiz doesn't even give you the correct answers. That's the problem. Like, if you did it wrongly, nobody will tell you what's the right answer. You have to go through it all. Which episodes feature Kit in his white undercoating? Interesting. Kit versus Scar and Trust Doesn't Rust. Okay. I first want to say Trust Doesn't Count was an auto-filling of my brain, but was wrong, sorry. Good Life Returns and Speed Demons? Junkyard? Yeah, Speed. It's rather fitting for the stream, maybe that's it. Okay. Jess says B, or people say A, that's A. Okay. Oh my god.
Strike wants to point out that Hasselhoff is Michael in this show. Just saying.
Thank you for the input.
As you can tell, he is a hardcore Knight Rider.
He is, yeah. Okay. Last question. Come on, 4 out of 10. Get it. What material does Kit have a hard time scanning through? Steel, lead, or copper? Copper, okay. See? Lead would make sense. B. Lead, okay. Lead wins. Well, that was correct. 4 out of 10. You're an average Knight Rider fan. We are a disgrace to this franchise. Sorry. Anyways, thanks for participating in this quiz. We did quite well. Except, I mean, the opposite. Next up is maybe the final game, I don't know. Spielt sonst auch? Fensteraufnahme oder Spielaufnahme? Was?
Wie das Spiel uns auch nimmt. Ging das hin? Leicht.
Müsst ihr wissen.
Fuck.
Warum hat es da?
I can assure you, Steam is running.
What?
Die Ingame-Auflösung ändern. Okay, weil ich glaube, die ist, wenn die falsch eingestellt ist, funktioniert es nicht. Weil das Fenster will ja auf 27 irgendwie graben. Hallo? Cool. Oh. Chat schreiben, we are on it. Ich glaube, denken, wir wollen einfach nur Nightrise. Danke. Sorry. We'll be right back. Okay, so I guess this is not happening because this game refuses to be played in window mode. Cool.
That's not the first time that this game causes troubles, so yes.
Fair enough, I have played this game in window mode before. Then again, I played the CD version and not the Steam version, so of course that's that has to be the problem here. I go through the options one last time, but I'm kind of out of hope here. Don't do this to me. Don't. Okay, still doesn't work. It was not my fault. This game is actually trash.
I can at Cataract.
I mean, they're
tier 5 bonus run. No, I'm sorry.
Things we're kind of out of short runs we could attach to the end of this stream.
Yes.
Well, I am. Of course, you may add something else.
I could. I have some half hour runs, but those would require download first, and I'm not too happy about them either. So
it's up
just
to
saying,
you.
No,
it's,
I think. Out of right now, I could not do one.
Okay.
Well.
I guess that was the stream then, or the marathon then.
The Tokarev.
Are there any closing words?
Right. No, we have
by
a
the
20 minutes Q&A session now.
Yes. If there are any questions, please ask them away and viel Spaß. of course. We may have some cool music. And maybe we can check what is there to host. So those are only streams I'm seeing. If you have any other ideas, feel free to. What? Like,
what?
Excuse me?
What the fuck?
Like, Eraser, what exactly, what precisely is wrong with you? I want a detailed...
Right, maybe not even precisely, just what is wrong.
Like, what is roughly wrong with you? I want a detailed report on my desk by Monday.
Like, what?
Fuck.
French. I guess.
What language is this?
Sorry for not speaking Swiss, German as released.
Thanks. GeoGuessr Co-op. I mean, what better way to...
It's Toka snoring.
Yeah.
Not to my knowledge.
Thanks. Anyway, so if you have any closing words, be free to... Maybe you should host because I'm not allowed to do that on your channel.
That would also be... What happened to TRU? TRU happened.
Yeah, we sadly didn't get to run it in win-out mode, because this was a rather spontaneous idea.
But yeah, I guess that's it then, isn't it?
I think so.
Good.
Thanks for watching, everybody.
Hope you had fun. I'm sure we had. Not just today, but yeah. Why am I still talking to at Tokaloni1? Why would I not be? I don't blame him for what happened yesterday.
Thank you.
I think that's what he wanted to hear. But yeah, this was all... I'm not even in camera, I just feel. And this was all put together very quickly, which I think you could see, especially on my runs. But yeah, thanks for watching. I don't know, we'll be back tonight. Probably not streaming, but... Not sure when you would try to stream again. Probably also
eventually.
Spontaneously, exactly. And yeah, thank you Toka for having me for almost 3 days. That was also fun, and I think most of you, or a good part of everyone in chat, I will see in 2 months. And the rest I will, I mean in person. And in chat I would be happy to see everyone sooner than that. including @Tokaloni1.